I just arrived in Hampi. It's 7 in the morning. Wait, yeah, it's 6:35. And the town is far more awake than I am. So I'm right now on the market side, but I booked accommodation on the Hampi Island side. So I'm just gonna have to walk through the ruins and stuff to get there. And there's gonna be a ferry that I have to take, and there's an auto that's gonna pick me up.
Hampi is a UNESCO World Heritage Site which is famous for ruins belonging to the erstwhile medieval Hindu kingdom of Vijayanagar. It also has its roots in Hindu mythology as the kingdom of Kishkindha, which was a monkey kingdom in the Ramayana. Hampi Island or Virupapura Gadde is a small island across the Tungabhadra River. To get there, you have to hop into a ferry and cross over. It gets its name because of the number of backpackers who choose to stay on this side of Hampi, and also because it has a very chill vibe. It takes maybe 2 minutes to cross the river. On the other side, my homestay had arranged for an auto to pick me up. So I hopped in and got going.
While to get to where I'm staying at a place called Jungle Tree Resort. It's really, really outside where all the other resorts are, but like I just booked yesterday, I didn't really find anything else. But it looks like a really beautiful property, and I'm just gonna have to figure out how I should be getting around over here. It's quite a bare bones accommodation. It's like a bamboo roof, and that's a bed. And you know, yeah, so I'm like all showered and fresh and good to go now. So the owner of the homestay I'm at, it's called Jungle Tree Homestay. Yeah, so the owner is taking me around on a bike today, and we're going to be exploring the northern part of Hampi, which is what a lot of tourists tend to avoid. Hampi itself is a UNESCO World Heritage Site, which is really famous for its ancient ruins. It used to be the ancient city of Vijayanagar, and for those of you who are familiar with Hindu mythological texts, Hampi is of great significance and is mentioned in the Ramayana. And there are actually remnants or memories of that scattered all over this little town, which I'm actually really kicked to see, because you know, who doesn't love seeing mythology come to life? This is Sagar. He owns the place and he's taking me around the northern side of Hampi today.
Let's see the Hampi and I'll show you in my style. Happy Hampi.
Awesome. Arrived at this place called Black Mountain, and you guys have to see the view from here. It is insane. This place is so quiet and so peaceful. You can practically hear the silence. It's just that serene. And Hampi is really famous for boulders. The thing is, no one knows where they came from. This used to be called Kishkindha, the monkey kingdom. So just a fun myth to play around with. Maybe they threw rocks at each other, or that's how they played, so that's why it looks like this now.
So while the locals love the legends, scientifically, tens of millions, even billions of years ago, these were all gigantic monoliths, and it's because of natural forces that all of these monoliths cracked, split, and eventually morphed into its present forms. Our next stop was someplace special and rather different. We came to the village of Anegundi, where we stopped at a unit that produces banana fiber handicrafts. It is run by a Belgian lady who moved to Hampi 35 years ago and has not left. Her aim, while producing handicrafts, is also to empower the local women here in Hampi.
For me, just money making would not be a goal in my life. It is just a requirement. Then I think the woman, they have access to many possibility of loan and city, and it's not the money they need. They need to wake up from inside.
She trains the women to make beautiful, sustainable products such as handbags and napkin holders, which are all for sale.
So we've now come to this waterfall-ish place. Yeah, I guess it's quite popular because there are quite a few people here.
A really fun and unique thing to experience in Hampi is a coracle ride.
Cool! These are little semi-circular boats made of bamboo, and it's like you're literally at level with the water. It feels so relaxing and peaceful, I can't tell you.
Cliff jumping is also a thing here in Hampi, but it's not supervised nor authorized, so at your own risk.
This was like super relaxing and so pretty and really nice, and I totally recommend one.
With that, we left Sanapur and made our way to Anegundi for the sunset. Anegundi is home to the Anjana Parvat, which according to Hindu mythology is the birthplace of Lord Hanuman.
Anjana was the mother of Hanuman, and this is said to be the place where he was born. So the temple at the top is the Anjanadri Temple, and there are 575 steps to get there. Whew, wish me luck. Ish to go. I can totally do this.
The temple is dedicated to Hanuman, and there are also idols of Ram and Hanuman's mother Anjana inside.
So I made it up here in like 15-20 minutes tops. It didn't take longer than that, and I'm glad I did because the views over here are unbelievable.
The sunset from there was spectacular, and I ended my first day in Hampi on such a beautiful note. Stay tuned for next week's video where we delve into the culture of this World Heritage site. I'll see you then!